Okay, so welcome back, guys. In this video, we'll be discussing about the female reproductive system. Okay, so today we'll be discussing about the basic anatomy, the basic physiology of the female reproductive system. We'll be discussing what is uterus, what is ovary. Okay, then what are the hormones which are secreted from the ovaries, and also about the regulation. So let's start. So this is the normal introduction, the normal anatomy of the female reproductive system. So what we can see here is a fallopian tube. Here, the pair of fallopian tube, you can see, I'll be marking here, you can see a pair of fallopian tube here, okay? And this is basically, this reproductive system is the coronal section. If you take the coronal section of the reproductive system, so this is how it looks, okay? So it has a pair of fallopian tube, a pair of ovary, okay, one vagina, uterus, fundus, okay? And these are the layers. The endometrium is the from inside out, it is endometrium, then the myometrium, okay? And this is the cervix, okay? So this is how it looks. So one by one, we'll be discussing about like what is the ovary, then what is fallopian tube, what is the uterus, okay? And what are the hormones which are secreted. Then after this, we'll be moving towards the menstrual cycle in the next class, okay? So we'll be discussing that, how this female sexual cycle takes place. So once we deal with this female sexual cycle, the menstrual cycle, then we will be moving towards the next, in the coming classes, we'll be going through how this pregnancy and parturition takes place, okay? So let's begin here. So one by one, I'll be discussing this. So this is the functional anatomy. This is how it looks via the side view, the lateral view or the sagittal view if we take. So this is how the female reproductive system looks. Okay. So the first point which I'll be discussing here is the ovary. So ovary, you can see here, this arrow marked here, this is the ovary. Okay. So this ovary, this produces eggs, which is called as the oocytes and hormones. The next thing which you can see is the uterine tubes. Okay. So this uterine tubes here, I'll be marking here, this arrow which is shown here, this is the uterine tube. The function of this uterine tube is to transport the eggs, okay, to transport the oocytes, okay. Now comes the next one, this is like then comes the uterus. Now this uterus is where the fetal development takes place, okay. And coming to the next point here, this arrow which is shown here, this is the vagina. This is the vagina or the birth canal, okay? And then comes the vulva, okay? This is the external genitalia which constitutes the vulva. And mammary glands, these are basically, these produce the milk, okay? So I'll be discussing that in the next slides. I'll also be discussing that how these mammary glands produce the milk, and this is in like what are the hormones which are responsible for ejection of milk and production of milk, okay? So one by one I'll be discussing. So let's go into the next slide. Now these are the ovary, okay? This is how a ovary looks when we do a cross section, like we do a coronal section, and this is how the ovary looks, okay? So if you take the histology, okay, if you take the histology, how it looks, first of all, the ovaries are the pair of organs, size of unshelled almonds in upper pelvic region, okay, and when we are talking about the histology, so this is how this looks. The first one here is the primordial follicle, okay, so this primordial follicle here, I have marked this arrow, this is like the capsule of dense connective tissue. So this has a capsule of dense connective tissue. This is the primordial follicle. Now coming to the next one is the primary preantral follicle. Okay. Then this here you can see about the cortex. The cortex just deep to the capsule. These contains the follicles with egg cells, which are called as the oocytes. Okay. So oocytes you can see here. The egg cells you can see here. The cortex. Okay. Now comes the another layer, this you can see is the medulla. Now this medulla is a middle region. This is composed of connective tissues, blood vessels and lymphatics, okay? So these are basically how these are getting its blood supply and nutrition. This is how it's getting. So this is the medulla. You need to know about this histology, because in the coming slides, in the coming lectures, we'll be dealing that how there are uterine changes, how there are ovarian changes, means how everything changes during the menstrual cycle, during the female sexual cycle, okay, and what happens during pregnancy. So these are the basics which you need to understand. Okay, then this arrow here, which is marked, this is the germinal epithelium. Okay, we are talking about the histology now. Then I'll be discussing that what are the like primordial follicles and this all. The follicles will be discussed in the next slide. Now this is the arrow which is marked here is the germinal epithelium. Okay, so this arrow here which is marked is the germinal epithelium. Okay, this germinal epithelium is the peritoneal membrane covering the ovary. So once again I'll be discussing this. This is the capsule of the dense connective tissue. Okay, this arrow, then the second one is the cortex, which is just deep to the capsule which contains the follicles with egg cells, oocytes. Then is the medulla in the middle region, which is composed of connective tissues and blood vessels and lymphatics. Okay, so this was about the ovary. Now we'll be moving through the ovarian follicles. Okay, so what are the ovarian follicles? These basically contain oocytes, okay, egg cells in various stages of development. So what these secretes, now this is important, these are secreting the estrogens. Okay, these estrogens functions for the number one point is the growth and repair of uterine lining. The second is the regulation of monthly female cycle. Okay, you need to remember these functions. The third is the female sexual characteristics. And the fourth is the maintenance of bone and muscle. Very important points. Okay, all are the, these all are the like the functions of estrogen, which are secreted from the oocytes, from the ovarian follicles. Okay, and a mature graafian follicle. These release the oocyte each month during ovulation. All right. So these are basically the ovarian follicles. Now we'll also be discussing about how this ovarian follicles looks in the diagrams. So let's go through this diagram here. This is important one. So make sure that you must be knowing all these stages from primordial from the primordial follicle to the mature what we call as the mature graafian follicle. These all stages you must be knowing, and then how this gets degenerated and how it releases the ovum. These things must be thorough to you people. Okay. So let's start here. The oocytes, these egg cells, these are developed within the follicles. Okay, and then what are the stages of follicular development? Very important. Okay, so the stages of follicular development, number one here is the primordial follicle. Okay, this primordial follicle is the single layer of squamous cell which surround the oocytes. Okay, so you can see here the primordial follicle. Now comes the primary follicle. Now this primary follicle here, okay, this arrow is marked here. This primary follicle, these are the layers of cuboidal granulosa cells. Okay, these cells are around the oocytes. Then comes the granulosa cells, which these granulosa cells basically secrete the estrogen. Okay, so this is important here. These granulosa cells are secreting the estrogen. This is a MCQ which is asked. Okay, so make sure that you people know this one by one. These all will be asked in your MCQs also, MCQs and in NEET exams, in your next exams. These are very important questions. Okay, so we have done with primordial follicle and the primary follicles. Okay, remember that these granulosa cells secrete the estrogens in the primary follicles. Now comes the third one. This is how the histology looks. Okay, coming to the secondary follicle here, now I'll be marking here. Okay, this arrow here, this is the secondary follicle or the antral follicle. Okay, here the antral follicles, here the antral cavity is formed. Okay, then is the next stage is the graafian follicle. Okay, here the follicle basically matures. Okay, ready to ovulate oocytes. Okay, so you can see here that here there is a follicular fluid in the antrum. Okay, when we see here the diagram, here there is follicular fluid in atrium, and then you can see the mature graafian follicle. Okay, then the next stage goes the ovulation. Okay, now this is the very this is the most important step. Here the in the ovulation the follicle ruptures and releases oocyte. Now just a second, I'll be marking here that Okay, now here the during this ovulation, here the follicle ruptures and this releases the oocyte. Now coming to this point here, this is corpus hemorrhagicum, okay, the ruptured follicle you can see here, and this is corona radiata, and this is the ovulation discharges a secondary oocyte. Okay, so remember this ovulation phase. Okay, now comes the next one. Now this after this like the ruptured follicle, what happens that after the ovulation the empty follicle becomes corpus luteum. Now this is the most important step. Remember what is corpus luteum, what are the hormones which are secreted from corpus luteum. Okay, now this corpus luteum here, after the ovulation the empty follicle becomes corpus luteum. Okay, remember this. So mark this slide here. Okay, this is corpus luteum, and what does this secretes? This secretes, the first one is the progesterone. This completes the preparation of the uterine lining. Okay, so the progesterone completes the preparation of the uterine lining, then comes the estrogen. This works with progesterone. Then the third one is the relaxin. Relaxin relaxes the uterine muscle and the pubic symphysis. And then comes the inhibin. Now inhibin decreases the secretion of FSH and LH, the follicular stimulating hormone and the luteinizing hormone. So these are the changes which occurs during the menstrual cycle. Okay, so how this corpus luteum, what this secretes, remember all these four hormones. Okay, the first one is the progesterone, the second is the estrogen, the third is relaxin, and the fourth is inhibin. So you also need to remember that how there are variations in the hormones during the menstrual cycle. So once you remember all these stages, and then in the next classes we'll also be discussing about the female sexual cycle. In that we'll be discussing that how this menstrual cycle takes place. Okay, all right. So remember this corpus luteum. Okay, after the ovulation this empty follicle is the corpus luteum. Okay, and the corpus albicans, this is the corpus luteum. Okay, always remember this diagram. Whenever, if it is asked, you people can draw and score a very good marks. Okay, then is the corpus albicans. Now this corpus albicans, this is a white scar tissue which is left after the corpus luteum is tied. Okay, all right. Now comes the phase of oogenesis. Now oogenesis is also important. This is the stage from oogonia to oocytes. All right. So these are basically the germ cells. In this oogenesis, you people have studied in your 12th and PMT exams. Now these are the germ cells from the yolk sac. Okay. This migrate to the ovary and become potential egg cells called as oogonia. So what happens is that in the fetal life, I'll be in the next slide, there is a flow chart, I'll be discussing this, but now let me read this. Like in the fetus there are million of oogonia which produce by mitosis, but most of them degenerate atresia. Okay, now some develop into the immature egg cells which are called as the primary oocytes during the fetal development. Okay, so there are total like 200,000, there are total 2 lakhs to 2 million present at birth, and then the 40,000 remain at puberty, but only 400 mature during the woman's reproductive life. Now these are the most important MCQs which are asked in your DNB exams, in your NEET exams, AIMS exams, everything there are asked. So how many millions, how many thousands, lakhs to millions are present in the at birth. So you have to say that the primary oocytes during the fetal development, there are 2 millions at birth. Okay, and how many remain at puberty? There are 40,000 which are remained, and during women's reproductive life there are 400 mature oocytes. Okay, during the woman's reproductive life. Now this point is also important. These each lines are containing MCQs and various one-liner answers. So each month about 20 primary oocytes becomes secondary oocytes. Okay, but usually one survives to be ovulated from the graafian follicle. Okay, so remember this, that there are 20 oocytes each month, there are 20 primary oocytes, these becomes the secondary oocytes, but usually only one survives to be ovulated from the graafian follicle. Okay, so we have discussed this oogenesis. Now is the flow chart. Now this is the flow chart which I have taken. Okay, this is the flow chart which I have taken from Jane Sir's book. So, okay, AK Jane I have taken here. This is the steps during oogenesis. Now, what happens during oogenesis? This is a very good diagram which you can see that at birth, at the fetal life, okay, it goes into oogonia. So, at the fetal life, there are at the 10th week onwards, you can see that the primary oocytes at birth is 2 million. Okay, I'll be marking here. Just a second. Okay. So, this is like, this is 2 million. Okay. Primary oocytes are 2 million at birth. Then, from birth to puberty, during the childhood phase, the first meiotic division begins. Okay. Now, this is a very important question. Just a second. This is a very important question that when does the first meiotic division occurs? Okay, here is your first meiotic division and the second meiotic division. Okay, so remember that from birth to puberty, at birth to puberty, the first meiotic division occurs. Okay, and then when does the from the primary oocytes to the secondary oocytes, the first meiotic division occurs. Okay, this begins at in the utero and it is completed at puberty. So this is an MCQ. Always remember this MCQ, that when first meiotic division occurs in females and when does the second meiotic division occurs in the female. Okay, so second meiotic division occurs, this is completed after fertilization. Okay, and the first meiotic division is completed at puberty, prior to the ovulation. Very important question, MCQs. These have been asked at least 10 to 15 times in your NEET exams. Okay, so remember this, and then comes the first polar body and the second polar body. Okay, so you need to know this flowchart. Once you remember this flowchart, these are the steps of oogenesis. Okay. All right, so this I have discussed that what are the counts. So counts are important, then during puberty, at birth, and during the female reproductive life, and then what is oogenesis, that what are the divisions and what are the different polar bodies, the first polar body and the second polar body. Okay, so also it comes about the chromosome cells. So the chromosomes per cell, this is like 46 in the fetal life, 46 at birth, and then at puberty the chromosomes per cell is 23, and that continues to be 23. And the chromatids per chromosome is during the fetal life it is 2, at birth it is 2, then puberty also it is 2, but then it continues to be 1 when it becomes ovum. Okay, all right. So remember this, I have made this presentation as a very concise and to the point. All right. Now comes the uterine or the fallopian tubes. Now what is, these are basically like, here you can see these are like the fallopian tubes are narrow 4-inch tube that extends from the ovary to the uterus. Okay. From the ovary to the, from the ovary to the uterus. Okay. So what you can see here, the first one here is the infundibulum. Now this one is the infundibulum. This is the opening. Okay, this is a funnel shaped portion near the ovary. Okay, so remember these terms. These are the infundibulum of the uterine tube. Fine. Now the next one is the fimbriae. Now here you can see these projections, which you can see these finger like processes. These are fimbriae. All right. So this is how your fimbria looks. Then comes the ampulla. Now this ampulla, which you can see here, this is the central region of the tube. Okay, so ampulla of the uterine tube, you can see in the arrow, and then is the isthmus. Now the isthmus is the narrowest part. I'll be marking here. Okay, so the isthmus here is the narrowest part of the uterine tube. All right. So the isthmus is the narrowest part of the uterine tube. And this is like, this is the uterus and the uterine cavity. You can see endometrium, myometrium, and the perimetrium. Then is the internal loss. This is the cervix of the uterus, cervical canal, lateral fornix. Okay. And this is the fundus of the uterus. So why I'm discussing about this anatomy? Because after studying this anatomy, you can also like go through the physio-anatomical aspect. Okay. Then you will be able to know that what are the hormones and what how this basically processes, what are the different mechanisms in which, like in menstrual cycle, how it occurs and what are the changes which are occurring here. So basics need, basics you have to know. Okay, so what is the function? Now comes the function part. Now the functions are the events which are occurring in the uterine tube. Okay, so what are the events? Make sure that you need to know. The first event here is the fimbriae sweep oocyte into the tube. Number one, okay, the first function here is that the fimbriae sweep the oocyte into the tube. Now the second one is the cilia and peristalsis move it along. Okay, so the cilia and the peristalsis move it along, and the third one is the sperm reaches the oocyte in ampulla. Okay, so the sperm here, the fallopian tube, if you see that the sperm reaches the oocyte in the ampulla, where does it reaches? In the ampulla. Okay, so one of the also if we talk about any applied aspect here, like if suppose the ovum is implanted, like the ovum is not in the ampulla, it is somewhere else, and it is matlab the ovum fails to descend in the uterus. So what happens that this leads to ectopic pregnancies and many more things. Okay, so ectopic pregnancies you will be studying in your ops gynae. You will be studying that how there are various different ectopic pregnancies. Okay, all right. So this point here is important. This point is like, sorry, this point here is fertilization. Now when does the fertilization takes place? So this occurs within 24 hours after ovulation. Now this is important. When does the fertilization takes place? This occurs within 24 hours after ovulation. And zygote, what is the timing of the zygote? The zygote reaches the uterus about 7 days after ovulation. Okay, so there are two questions which are asked. The first one is the when does the zygote reaches the uterus after ovulation? That is your answer is 7 days. Okay, and when does the fertilization occurs within after ovulation? So that is your answer is 24 hours. Okay, so we have discussed two MCQs here. So let's move on to the next slide. Okay, so this is the anatomy of the uterus. We have discussed the anatomy of the fallopian tube. Okay, uterine and fallopian tube. Ovaries also we have discussed. Now we'll be discussing about the anatomy of the uterus. Okay, so this uterus here, which you see, is the site of menstruation and development of uterus. Okay, so this is how its description, 3 × 2 × 1, very simple. Okay, this dimension is very simple. This is asked in your anatomy viva also. It is asked in your exams also, like what is the dimensions of here. So always remember that this is 3 × 2 × 1, 3 inches long. Okay, 1 minute. So this is 3 inches long. Okay, 2 inches in width and 1 inches in thickness. Okay, then it is subdivided into fundus, body and cervix. Okay, and the interiorly it contains uterine cavity which is assessed by the cervical canal. So this is how it looks. Okay, it has the broad ligament, it has the overhand ligament, the suspensory ligament. Okay, so this is the histology of the uterus. Now when we see here, it has 3 layers from okay, the first one is the endometrium, then is the myometrium, then is the perimetrium. Now endometrium here is simple columnar epithelium. These are very important. Okay, this is simple columnar epithelium. You can see here that this is the stroma of the connective tissues and endometrial glands. What are the function? Function is they shed during the menstruation. Okay, so mark here, this is an MCQ which is asked that what is the function of the endometrium. So these are basically the stroma of the connective tissues and the endometrial glands, and the function is that these shed during menstruation. So one by one I am discussing this. When we'll be discussing the menstrual cycle, we'll be combining this unanimously, and we'll come to know that what are the changes which occurs in the uterus, okay, uterine endometrium, what are the changes which occurs, then what are the changes which occurs in the ovaries, okay, what are the changes which occurs in the hormones. Okay, so all these 4-5 we have to combine that in the menstrual cycle, and we have to see that what are these sequence of events which are occurring in 28 days of menstrual cycle. So this is the reason why we are studying this anatomy. Basics we have to know, the basics of anatomy and physiology, what are the functions. Okay, so the functional layer we have seen. Now comes the basal layer. Okay, the basal layer here, this replaces the functional layer each month. Okay, so endometrium we have discussed. Now comes the myometrium. Now, myometrium here has three layers of smooth muscle. So here you can see endometrium you have seen here. Okay, this is the myometrium. This has three layers of smooth muscle. So remember that where are smooth muscles present? Apart from this, the smooth muscles are also present in your blood vessels and in the viscera's, in your eyes. You need to remember as a holistic approach. Okay. Then comes the perimetrium. Now perimetrium here is the visceral peritoneum. Now this perimetrium, which you can see, is this is the visceral peritoneum. Okay. So endometrium we have discussed that these are simple columnar epithelium. Oh, all right. This is the endometrial stroma and endometrial gland. Very important to know histology, because there are many pathologies where this stroma and the gland are like these differs. Okay, there are many pathologies, and this is your endometrium, the stratum functionalis and the stratum basalis. Okay, these were the layers. Now let us go to the next slide. Sorry. Now comes the vagina. Vagina is the passage of birth, menstrual flow and intercourse. Now its description is, this is 4 inches long, fibromuscular organ ending at the cervix. This lies between the urinary bladder and the rectum, and this orifice partially, it is closed with the membrane, hymen. Okay. Alright, so after discussing vagina, now we'll come to the mammary glands. Now mammary glands is important. Okay, mammary glands, there are many questions which are asked, then there are many pathologies of the mammary gland. So let us come to the very basic. This mammary gland is the modified sweat glands that produce the milk, that is lactation. Okay, so in the coming slides, like in your endocrine system, in your CNS, there will be various questions which are asked on oxytocin and milk ejection reflex, and like what are the positive feedback effect which we can see in milk ejection reflex. You have to draw those diagrams. So these are the basics which you know. You have to know this. Here the amount of adipose tissue determines the size of the breast. Okay, and then the milk secreting mammary glands, alveoli, opens in the lactiferous duct at the nipple, and the areola is pigmented area around the nipple, and there are the suspensory or the Cooper ligaments. Very important. These are the MCQs which are asked. These suspensory or Cooper ligaments, these suspend the breast from the fascia, deep fascia, to the pectoral region. Okay. So this is how it looks. I'll be zooming this. Okay. These are the like suspensory Cooper ligaments. You can see the lobes of the mammary gland. You can see. Then these are the lactiferous duct, you can see here, then the areola, nipple, and the lactiferous sinus. All right. Okay. Now this is the next slide. Now this slide is the physiology of breast. Okay. Milk production and milk secretion. There are two things. Okay. How this milk is produced and how this milk is secreted. So remember all these four hormones, and these are like repeatedly they have asked multiple times. Okay. In your NEET exams, in your everything, like whatever exams you are going giving, you need to know this by heart. The first thing is the estrogen. Now these estrogen develops the duct system in the breast. So what are the functions of estrogen in the breast? These estrogen develops the duct system in the breast. Okay. Now progesterone develop the milk secreting glands, which are called the alveoli. So remember this. What is the function of estrogen? This function of estrogen is the, these develop the duct system. And what is the function of progesterone? These develop the milk secreting glands, which are called as the alveoli. All right. Now comes the most important thing, that is the prolactin. This prolactin stimulates the milk synthesis. Okay. Milk synthesis or milk production. These are the functions of prolactin. Okay. Milk synthesis or milk production. Okay. And what are the functions of oxytocin? These stimulates the milk ejection. Don't confuse this with milk production or milk synthesis. Okay. The main function of oxytocin is that this oxytocin helps in milk ejection. Okay, from the alveoli. Okay. So like milk ejection reflex, there will be question which will be asked on oxytocin. Like what oxytocin does, what is the function of oxytocin? how oxytocin is released from like your pituitary gland, from the posterior pituitary to the, like, what are the reflexes which are present, how a positive feedback effect is taking place. So all you need to know about this is oxytocin, that how milk ejection reflex takes place. You need to know that how that cycle takes place, okay? That positive feedback effect, that positive feedback cycle takes place, okay? And oxytocin also has a very important role in parturation. Okay, during your delivery, it's very important that how this oxytocin is secreted, and that leads to like much more contraction of the uterus and much more contraction of the uterine muscles. Then that leads to the delivery of the baby. So prolactin, the prolactin is important for lactogenesis. Okay, I'll be mentioning here that prolactin is important for lactogenesis. Okay, and this is oxytocin, is this is important for milk ejection. Okay. Alright, so we have discussed all these things, we have discussed about the basic anatomy, we have discussed about the basic physiology, the basic functions, okay. So now in the what are the physiology of the mammary glands, if we go little more here about the milk ejection which are released from the glands. So this here, this nursing stimulates the hypothalamus, okay, and this hypothalamus produces the oxytocin. You people have studied in your endocrine that how oxytocin milk ejection reflex is taking place. Now this oxytocin is released from the posterior pituitary, again very important MCQs, these all are MCQs, you know. Then oxytocin causes the smooth muscles around the alveoli to contract and squeezes the milk into the lactiferous ducts, alright, and this lactiferous sinuses and into the nipple, alright, and this is operated via the positive feedback effect. Alright, this is operated via the positive feedback effect. These all are must know MCQs that this should be learned thoroughly, okay, by you people. So we have discussed about the milk ejection, these are released from the glands. So in today's class we have discussed about the anatomy and the physiology, the basic introduction of the female reproductive system. And we have also discussed about what is the uterus, what are the hormones which are secreted and what are the functions which are seen. Then we have discussed about the ovaries, the hormones which are released and what are the functions. And then we have discussed the mammary gland, the hormones which are acting on this and what are the main functions of these hormones. Okay. So today now we are ending this class. We have discussed about the basics. In the next class, I'll be discussing in detail about what are the female sexual cycles, okay, what are the changes which are seen during menstrual cycle, and what are the changes, the hormonal fluctuations and everything, we'll be discussing that in the menstrual cycle class, okay. So, thank you so much guys, okay.